tonight, Commissioner Keller, so we'll leave us in the prayer and pledge.
Okay, shall we pray? Dear Heavenly Father, Creator of heaven and earth, we just come to you tonight to ask your blessing on our decisions and guidance on our decisions. We ask your blessing on Catoosa County and all that protect her, and all the citizens, Lord, who live in the county. We just ask for your benevolence, and we ask that you watch over us and guide us. We ask these things in your name. Amen. Salute.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Commissioner Johnson?
Here.
Commissioner Cutler?
Here.
Chairman Henry?
Here.
Commissioner Winn?
Here.
Commissioner Law?
Here.
At this time, is there any items to add or remove from the agenda? Do I have a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Does everyone look over the minutes from the last January 18 meeting? Do I have a motion to approve the minutes?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor of approving the minutes as is?
Aye.
Aye.
At this time, do we have any appearances?
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, I'm Jill Sweet, County, and I've got a copy of the rules that y'all drew up for the credit cards. And I have been pulling some of these credit cards on certain commissioners, but there's two commissioners I'd like to thank, because Chris Washington turned nothing in. So therefore, that y'all's business, but thank you. But this other one is really a mess, and I think it stepped on a several people's toes about that, and I would really request that you all look at your rules, and then you should write a rule that those cards should never be used for your spouse. I don't care what you're doing with it, but you should never use it for your spouse. And there's two instances in these tickets that I have that one of you commissioners used that card to buy a plane ticket and extra rooms and room service, and this county is not in the business for that. And I think that if you're going to come back and pay for a ticket or a hotel room, you should pay for it in the very beginning, because we're not here to treat your families to anything. We're here to not even to judge you. We're here to keep check on you. And these papers right here are keeping check on the commissioner that did that. And the public needs to know exactly that, because I think y'all may have stepped over one of these lines. And I do want to apologize to the chairman for being out of order at the last meeting. What come out of my mouth has never done that before. And I'm sure that it won't do it again, but I was just real curious as to why meeting was being called off. Thank you.
Anybody else? This time we'll move on to administrative fiscal matters. I think Gary, are you going to present since Mr. Walker has lost his voice, or raising on that so boy?
Yeah, I've been asked to be the spokesperson in this group. I don't know about that.
You are the best answer, Gary.
I figured we'd heard a lot more applause when we said Mr. Walker lost his voice. I don't
know. Did I sue you?
We come before you to ask for ratification of a new 911 EMA director. Just to kind of tell you a little bit about how that process went down, we have a number of applicants. We're up to 29 applicants. I was asked to go through the applications. selected people for interviews, called a number of people in for first round interviews, and then tried to narrow that down to about three applicants. And I think we've got a real good applicant here. Our applicant that the group has selected is Dennis Thayer. He's 30-plus years in emergency services. He lives in the Bartow area. He's here tonight to answer questions if the board so desires, but I think he's got leadership qualities that can really move our 911 center forward and our emergency services. He'll definitely be a benefit to the county, and I would want to look forward to working with him. And I appreciate the county manager asking me to sit in on the process. Sheriff's Office is a high-volume user of the 911 center, so we'll be working a lot together. But I look forward in that. I think he can really help move some things forward with our communications and emergency services. Okay, so his start date would be March the 5th, Monday.
Do I have a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Comments, questions?
We'll hold.
Yeah, thank you very much. Mr. Walker, I did want to thank you for the process. I appreciate you including Sheriff and Chief and Steve. People are going to be most affected. I think that was great. Look forward to working with you, sir.
Thank you. I look forward to it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Didn't mean to cut you off.
I knew you.
No, I didn't want anybody to hear you.
Thank you very much. Jeff Paul, Martin Way, Chairman Stephen Henry, Jeff Cutler, Bishop Curry, and Wayne Washington. Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Donald Brown.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, Commissioners. I'm here to make a request to declare county fixed asset surplus. These items will be either auctioned, gov deals, or disposed of depending on the condition of each item. These items include vehicles, miscellaneous equipment, miscellaneous parts, office furniture, and equipment.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Questions or comments from Mr. Brown? Glad we've got the good out of most of these. $276,000. All in favor?
Aye.
You're up again, Mr. Brown.
Okay, Mr. Chairman, this was a surplus vehicle we had last year. We had it on gov deals, and it's a 1986 Ford E350 Econo Line communications vehicle. Actually, the city of Ringo had approached me last year when it was being auctioned, and they had been searching for a vehicle to meet their needs for supervisor for them. And so they identified the vehicle, they took the vehicle and used it, and so they really liked it. And so the request that I'm asking for tonight is to transfer the ownership from the county to the city of Ringo for 1986 Ford E350 Econo Line.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Do I have any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you, Mr. Brown. Mr. Patty.
Is there anyone here from the Public Process Center? Mr. Chairman, this is our annual ratification of a memorandum of understanding with the Family Process Center of Walker Day, Catoosa, and Chautauqua Counties. It's located in all of the counties in the Lookout Mountain Judicial Circuit. The Family Crisis Center provides a 24-hour crisis line, emergency shelter for victims of domestic violence, safety planning for residential and non-residential victims of violence. They provide legal advocacy services, provide to victims of domestic violence appropriate referrals, provide domestic violence support groups for victims of domestic violence, provide financial assistance if funding allows for victims of domestic violence, and provide follow-up services and support. They also provide community education and confidentiality for all the people who go through the Family Crisis Center. Annually, for those services, we budget a stipend in the amount of $10,000. And annually, we ratify the memorandum of understanding that we have with the Family Crisis Center. We've done this for 2 years.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Any questions or skips? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Skips. Carl Henson. That's how Carl is a little pale.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I've got proposed approval of a deputy change order for Brown Brothers. And this relates to the Three Knots Sewer Project, which the bulk of this was provided for in the 2009 SPLOST cycle. The original contract price was $6,930,729. After all the quantities were accounted for, the project was finished under budget, and therefore the deputy change order is required to close the project. The deductive change order is in the amount of $176,362, bringing the new contract to $6,754,367.
Do I have a motion to approve this change order?
So moved, sir.
Second.
Commissioner, have they finished up the curbing out there? There's been a lot of people complaining about curbing.
There's a little bit of minor restoration work to be finished in the spring.
Oh, I think there's...
And they provide any of that.
That correct, Carl?
Pardon?
I think there's still some retaining.
Oh, yeah. We did not pay out the retainment company.
Sound like a good deal. We'll get the $100,000 off that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carl?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. We finished up the fiscal year 2017, and we need to, we're required to do a budget amendment. Because for financial reporting purposes on governmental funds, budgeted revenue by source must be equal to or less than actual revenue, and budgeted expenditures must be by department must be equal to or greater than actual expenditures. The general fund, county general fund, received $717,000 more revenue than previously anticipated. Current fiscal year. And although having required to meet changing governmental expenses and needs, the county was able to accomplish those needs with $1,853,000 less than anticipated expenditures. Therefore, actual revenue exceeded actual expenditures by $2,570,000. After the year-end redistribution of the budgeted revenue and expenditure, actual revenue exceeded the amended revenue by $1,274,000. Actual expenditures were less than amended expenditures, $1,296,000. Therefore, favorable to amended budget, $2,570,000. In summary, general fund, the amendment was to reduce the general fund by $556,520, bringing the amended budget to $24,947,693. And on the other governmental funds, the amendment was to increase the budget by $2,540,562, bringing the amended budget to $10,003,916. On capital project funds, the amendment was to increase it by $121,447, bringing the amended budget to $12,121,447. Enterprise funds, amendment was to increase the budget by $28,293, bringing the amended budget to $423,293. In total, all budgeted funds, the amendment was to increase the budget by $2,133,782, bringing the budget for all funds $47,496,349.
That includes the amendment. Do I have a motion?
Second.
Questions for Paul? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay, I'd like to report on the sales tax revenue for the 4 month period ended in January. The cumulative loss receipts for the first 4 months of the current fiscal year are favorable to budget $181,000 by 8.1%. and favorable to the same 4 month period prior year, $144,800, or 6.3%. The lost receipts for the most recent 12 months were favorable, $264,000, or 3.9%. On the splash receipts for the 42 month period of the 2014 splash cycle, we've collected $34,267,000, currently at 81.6% of budget. SPLOST receipts for the most recent 12 months was favorable, $377,000, or 3.9% compared to the prior 12 months. So we're still trending, good trend toward the first 4 months of the cycle. And also it's reflected in the financial report in that I would like to report on the general fund for the first 3 months of the current fiscal year, period ending December. The operating revenue for the period was $6.5 million. We're currently 25% through the current fiscal year. The operating revenue was 25.2% of budget, therefore exceeded the budget by $51,885, or 0.8%. But exceeded prior year $317,000, or 5.1%. The operating expenditures for the period were $5,751,000. 23.2% of budget, therefore less than budget, $441,863, by 7.1%, but exceeded prior year by $89,758, by 1.6%. In summary, after other financing sources and uses and operating transfers out, revenue exceeded expenditures for the period, $605,314, favorable to budget, $605,314, and favorable to prior year, $291,312. So we're still trending at $200,000 a month favorable.
Thank you. This time we have no old business, and we move on to our new business, Skip.
Mr. Chairman, we have a vacancy on the Lookout Mountain Community Services Board. There is one vacancy. It's for a two-year term. We have one applicant for that position, Clarence Crump. And based on his letter, which has been delivered to the board, he appears to be certainly qualified to serve as on the Lookout Mountain Community Service Board.
I have a motion to approve Clarence Crump.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Chad?
Mr. Chairman and Board, this item and the next item on the agenda are both in connection with the proposed 2019 SWOS cycle. The current SWOS cycle that we are in began in 2014 and runs through the end of June 2019. And in order for the current SWOS to continue for another five-year cycle beginning in 2019, we're required to put this matter back on the ballot for election. The proposal is to put the matter on the ballot for election on May the 22nd of this year. And in connection with anticipating the SWOS election coming up, the two cities, the county and the utility district, have met several times and negotiated an intergovernmental agreement for how the SWOS proceeds the next cycle would be divided and for what projects they would be used for. The intergovernmental agreement is what's before the board now. It has been adopted and signed by the city of Ringgold, the city of Portland, and the utility district, and it is before the board now for you to consider on this item.
Do I have a motion to approve the intergovernmental agreement?
So moved.
Second. Questions for Mr. Kemp? All in favor of approving the intergovernmental agreement, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
The next item, Mr. Chairman, is the SWOS is ultimately a county tax that the Board of Commissioners has to put on the ballot, so the Board of Commissioners is required to adopt a resolution which would issue the call for the election. Again, it would be on March the 22nd, and it would put a referendum on the ballot for the voters of the county to decide whether they want to continue the current 1 cent sales tax SWOS for another 5 year cycle. If it passes, the collection would not begin until July 1 of 2019, which is when the current cycle would expire.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Any questions on this? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you, Skip. Thank you, Jeff.
Capital County Manager, pass it on to just to thank Chief Quinn for stepping up and keeping the 911 under control during this time, and also thank the some of the staff for being here tonight to support the new director. It means a lot when you see the employees that comes up, steps up, but let them know we appreciate it.
I'd just like to echo those same sentiments. Thank you, and welcome to our new director who's left. We're glad to have a very qualified person on board for 911. Thank you all for coming and participating in our meeting tonight.
Any other? At this time, we want to go into executive session. Do I have a motion to do so?
For legal and personnel.
For legal and personnel.
For legal and for personnel.
I'll say. All in favor? Melissa's here, how long now? I've been messed up. Will you call her real quick?
Commissioner Johnson?
Yes.
Commissioner Cutler?
Yes.
Chairman Henry?
Here.
Commissioner Whitaker?
Yes.
Commissioner Long?
Yes.
Thank you. We're in executive session. Page and page. This time, do I have a motion to come out of executive session?
So.
Second.
All in favor of coming out of executive session, say aye.
Aye.
Out of executive session. We have nothing for open session. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
So.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Or adjourn.
That's all. You hear it?
Oh, yeah.